Welcome to Time of Death. This video is for informational purposes and in no way meant to glorify or condone violence. In today's video, we'll be discussing the murder of Erwin Escobar. Escobar was shot and killed Monday, September 24th, 2007, in the 100 block of South Kenmore Avenue in Koreatown, according to LA County Coroner records. Richard Alvarez was subsequently arrested and charged with the murder. The following is the evidence at trial. On September 24th, 2007, the victim, Erwin Escobar, then 14 years old, accompanied his brother, a friend, and his friend's cousin in a white car to purchase a vehicle for his brother. Between 9 p.m. and 10 p.m. that evening, the group, two in the white car and two in the car purchased by Escobar's brother, returned to the apartment building where Escobar lived. They planned to attend a birthday celebration for Escobar's mother that night. The apartment building was in territory claimed by 18th Street, a rival of Rockwood, although neither Escobar nor any of the others in his group was from 18th Street. As the group stood outside talking to Escobar's mother, who was on the balcony looking at the vehicle just purchased, defendant Alvarez, a Rockwood gang member known as Baby Shadow with prominent Rockwood tattoos, approached with another man known as Little G, screaming, "18th Street, are you guys down with the E? You guys down with the neighborhood?" Alvarez walked three times around the white car in a gang-affiliated way, which some said resembled dancing but served the purpose of pumping fear into other people. Alvarez repeated the comments about 18th Street in a tone that was accelerated, energized as though he was under the influence, but did not slur his words or talk fast. Alvarez then pointed the gun at Escobar and fired five rounds. He and his companion ran from the scene. Escobar died of multiple gunshot wounds. About an hour later, Alvarez and his companion appeared at a taco truck operated by Alberta Diaz in territory claimed by Rockwood, approximately 2 miles from the scene of the shooting. Diaz recognized Alvarez and his companion. Alvarez ordered Diaz to give him food and showed her the gun in his waistband. Alvarez spoke in a loud voice, saying bad words, asking Diaz, "Do you know who I am?" and showing her his Rockwood tattoos. He mentioned the name Shadow and said Rockwood was in charge. Diaz thought Alvarez was drunk and on drugs, and he acted very angry and excited, but not crazy. Diaz told Alvarez to calm down because she feared for her life and the life of her daughter who was in the truck, and gave him food although he didn't pay for it. About that time, a marked police car approached. Alvarez became nervous and said, "I killed the fucker," to Diaz, and tried to hand her the gun. When Diaz did not take the gun, Alvarez tossed it and it landed inside the taco truck. Four casings found at the scene where Escobar was shot were of the same caliber as those recovered from Escobar's body during the autopsy, and all of the casings were fired from the gun that landed inside the taco truck. After tossing the gun, Alvarez, holding a burrito, walked away from the taco truck at a quick pace. The police directed him four or five times to stop, and Alvarez yelled back at them in a loud and aggressive tone using bad language. Alvarez finally turned around and stopped, and the police arrested him. A police officer testified as an expert on Rockwood, describing 18th Street as one of its principal enemies. Defendant Alvarez, based on his tattoos and admissions to the police, was a Rockwood gang member. Given the hypothetical based on the evidence of Escobar's death, the officer opined that the shooting of Escobar was committed for the benefit of, at the direction of, or in association with Rockwood. According to the officer, going into enemy territory, hunting for victims, and then killing an innocent boy would put fear and intimidation into the rival gang's territory and elevate the status of both Rockwood and the individual gang member. Following the trial, the jury found Alvarez guilty of first-degree murder and second-degree robbery, including a gun and gang enhancement. The court sentenced Alvarez to life without the possibility of parole plus 50 years. Erwin Escobar was 14 years old at the time of death.